Let's take a moment and talk about chemical and physical changes. Get out your science notebook to take notes in. Here's the essential question. Write this at the top of your page and really focus on it throughout these notes. How do we recognize chemical and physical changes? Let's make a T-chart in your notes. On one side, let's put chemical change. On the other side, let's put physical change. What we're going to explore for each of these is their definitions, some examples, as well as some evidences to recognize them. Here's the definitions for each. A physical change is a change that affects one or more physical properties or characteristics of a substance without changing the chemical identity of that substance. And we're talking about the chemical formula. A chemical change, on the other hand, is a change when one or more substances react, and they do change the chemical identity into an entirely new substance. If these don't quite make sense now, that's okay. We're going to go through some examples, and hopefully they'll start to make more sense. Let's take a look at our first example, flammability. I've got a question for you. Is this a chemical or a physical change? If you said that this was a chemical change, you're exactly right. Let's take a closer look at what's happening chemically at this reaction that you're seeing on the left side. These are match heads. Now, match heads have different formulas. There's different types of matches, such as safety matches and strike anywhere matches. What we're looking at right here is the type of chemical formula for strike anywhere matches. On the top of, or the tip of the match head, there are typically two substances, tetraphosphorus trisulfide and potassium chlorate. When these two substances get frictioned together, either striking on the matchbox or on a surface, those substances both react together and cause that match head, that match tip, to ignite and cause a flame. Now, those substances chemically change into new substances that you see down here on the other side of that reaction arrow. What about density? Density is the compactness of matter. If we cause a change in density of something, is that a chemical or a physical change? Well, if you said physical change, you're exactly right. Here's an example of two substances. Maybe these substances are carbon dioxide. Here's a lower density carbon dioxide. This could be maybe in a gas form. If we somehow get those substances to compact themselves together, we might be able to cause them to be more dense, but we're not changing the substance itself. It's still carbon dioxide. What about melting? If we cause a substance to melt, is it going through a chemical change or a physical change? This one's a little bit challenging, and some people get it wrong, but melting is a physical change. Think about it. Here we have an ice cube. What's that ice cube made out of? Well, it's made out of water in a solid form. If we cause that ice cube to melt, we're changing the ice's physical state. It's going from a solid to a liquid, but we're not changing its chemical state. It's still water. The same is true if I reverse this. If I cause that water to freeze, it's still a physical change. What if I change the luster of something? Here I have a coin. On one side, it's super shiny or lustrous. On the other side, it's tarnished or dull. Well, changing the luster of something is a physical change. We're not changing the chemistry. We're not changing the chemical identity of the substance. What about a color change? This one's a little bit more challenging, and it kind of is situational depending on what you're looking at. So color change can be either chemical or a physical change depending on what we see. Let's take a look at our two examples here. Let's start with this first one. This one is a precipitation reaction. Notice that we're mixing two different substances and they almost look clear. But when those two substances mix, we cause a color change. This red substance comes out of nowhere. It wasn't in either of the substances to begin with. This is a precipitation reaction. These two starting substances are solutions that are aqueous. And when we mix them together, they form something that's called a precipitate. And that precipitate has a completely different chemical identity than the two substances that they had before it. So over here on the left side, this is a chemical change. Now right here, this is a physical change. What you're seeing is red dye number 40. This is a dye that's in powdered form, often found in many foods and food colorings. Now when that red dye is in its solid form, you can put it in water, and all that's happening is it's dissolving, but it's not changing its chemical formula. We're going from a solid substance to an aqueous substance. That chemical dye is not changing the chemical identity of itself or the water. It's just mixing. It's creating a mixture. So that is a physical change. All right, what about reactivity? If you said chemical change, you're exactly right. What we're looking at here is hydrogen peroxide. And hydrogen peroxide decomposes into water and oxygen. This is called an elephant toothpaste reaction that causes that reaction to happen fairly quickly by adding something called a catalyst. But that's hydrogen peroxide decomposes into oxygen gas and water, and that oxygen gas causes this elephant toothpaste reaction to bubble up. So here's kind of the key idea. Physical changes have no change in the chemical identity, right? For example, melting, this water molecule starts off at water, still ends up as water. It doesn't matter what phase it is in. A chemical change, on the other hand, changes the chemical identity of the substance. Here's propane gas, and if you mix it with oxygen, you can ignite it. This would be like in a propane barbecue grill, and it changes into carbon dioxide and water when you set it on fire. All right, evidences for chemical change. Typically, we can't see atoms with our eyes, so it's not really easy for us to know whether a chemical change is taking place because we can't see what's happening at the molecular level. So we have to rely on evidences. And here are six different evidences that you would see to really get an idea of whether a chemical change is taking place. The first one is forms of precipitate. If we mix two things and we get a solid substance coming out of this is called a precipitate. This is an example of evidences that a chemical change is taking place. If we mix substances and it emits a gas where there was no gas before, that's a chemical change or evidence that a chemical change is taking place. If a substance that typically had one odor starts producing a different odor, or if it had no odor and starts producing an odor, that is evidence that a chemical change is most likely taking place. If it emits light, I like to think of like glow sticks. When you snap a glow stick, light is emitted. Or a campfire. If you light something on fire and fire continually is produced through flame, those are examples of light being emitted, and those are examples of evidences for chemical change. Now, color change, we talked about this one before. You got to beware. If it produces a color that wasn't there before, then that is evidence for a chemical change. And a temperature change, here's another example of evidence for chemical change. If you mix two substances and then all of a sudden that substance at room temperature gets really hot or really cold, then that is evidence that chemical change is taking place. Now, not one of these is necessarily perfect. We need, the more evidences we see of these things, the more likely there is that a chemical change is taking place. How about for physical changes? Well, here's some examples of evidences for physical change. A shape change. If the substance goes through shape change, it's not changing its chemical formula. It may be cut in half or broken or shattered or put together. We're not changing the substance, we're just changing its shape. The texture, we could be causing a texture change. Again, we're not changing the chemistry of the substance, we're just changing its texture, the way it feels. Color change or color added would be more appropriate for a physical change. By adding food coloring to something, we're not causing a color change, we're just dyeing it with color. A phase change, changing from a solid to a liquid, or a liquid to a solid, or a solid to a gas. Again, we're not changing the chemical structure of the substance, we're just changing its phase. We're changing potentially its density and the way the intermolecular forces interact with one another. Temperature as well, you need to watch out for. Some things can change their temperature because something is acting upon them. They're not producing a temperature change, they're just being caused a temperature change by things around them. All right, that leads us to the end of the notes. Take a moment to review and highlight key terms, ponder and ask questions, and summarize and answer the essential question. Good luck.